brought to you by ExpressCare Health and Skin Center. Get in, get out, get better.
Welcome back to Healthy Living. Tonight we are talking about nail health. What is their purpose and how can people stop biting their nails? Well, joining me now is ExpressCare's Dr. Jitka Lom, who has the answers. Welcome, Doc.
Nice to see you again.
Yes, you too. So, what role does the nail play? Is it really needed?
Most of the time it is needed. The tip of the nail, the tip of the finger needs protection from falling objects, for example. So the nail is a hard buffer between us and the environment. And the other purpose of the nail is in a gripping or clawing function, so we can use it as a tool when we are peeling oranges, for example. So the nail has a couple of useful purposes there. Nail health is very important. So you can tell a lot by a person's inside health by looking at their nails.
Oh, okay. So can you share with us, what is nail psoriasis and is it common?
There's an example. People that have the disease of psoriasis, which is a skin disease, they tend to have plaques on their skin, sometimes in their hair, dandruff, and so on. And they will also have changes on their nails. They'll have pitting, their little bumps in the nails. They'll have thickened nails, yellowish nails, nails that are lifting up off of the fingertip, so they'll be kind of loose, discolored. And quite ugly, actually, most of the time, and they're very difficult to treat. So nail psoriasis, most of the time it goes along with the skin disease. Some of the time it's only just the nails that are affected.
Okay. Now, does diet play a big part in the health and strength of your nails?
It does play a bit of a role. For people who are extremely malnourished, they'll have very weak and brittle nails. For the general population that eats a reasonable diet, their nails will be okay. But if people have metabolic diseases such as diabetes or thyroid disease or kidney disease, people that are on dialysis, they will have changes in their nails that are apparent when you look at them. Another example would be people with lung diseases, for example, asthma or chronic bronchitis. They will have changes on the tips of their fingers and on the nails also.
Okay, so what about during pregnancy? How is the nail affected during pregnancy?
Well, one thing women notice is the nails grow much faster than usual during pregnancy. Sometimes they'll be a little weaker, but in general, that's a time of strength and health for women, and so their nails will be in pretty good shape.
Okay.
Yes.
So is there anything that you can take, vitamins, for example, that can help strengthen and even grow your nails longer?
There are a lot of things out there on the market, aren't there? Unfortunately, I think most of them actually have not been proven to be effective at all. The only one that is somewhat helpful is biotin, which you can purchase in a vitamin shop. But all the other supplements are for your general health, sort of vitamins and so on, minerals. But the keratin that the nail is made from is similar to the substance that your hair is made out of, and none of the supplements are that effective for it. It's more your overall general health and also your genetics as far as how healthy your nails will be.
Okay. Now, can you permanently damage your nails? For example, if you slam the door on your nail and then it turns all black, or you know, it falls off, or there's dents in your nails. So can you permanently damage your nails when you stub them or slam them?
You can. If you do slam something on your fingernail and it turns black, that's a little tiny blood clot under the nail. It's usually very painful. You can feel your heartbeat in it, it's throbbing. And you can quickly go to a clinic and have them what we call trephinate, meaning put a tiny hole in the fingernail itself. That is not painful. It takes about 1 second. And you place a hole in the nail, release the pressure, and then the blood no longer accumulates, doesn't cause that trauma, long-term damage. You'll still have a sore nail, the nail still may come off, but you won't have a permanently damaged and ugly nail. So that's a tip. If you get a blood clot under the nail, try to have the pressure released.
Okay. Now, I've seen individuals with really long nails, and they tend to kind of curve like a hook, or they're kind of dark in color.
Yes.
Is there a reason why it does that?
Yeah, that's a great question. Well, there's a couple of reasons. First one is, as people age, their nails will tend to get yellowish anyway. And so sometimes you see those really long nails on elderly people, especially if they haven't been able to physically trim their nails, especially on toenails. But as far as the curving, that's something that occurs because our nail is actually held in place by our finger. So the longer the nail gets, the less tissue there is to hold it in place, and it will naturally tend to slope down. As far as the discoloration, the longer the nail is, the older it is, just like hair, kind of like split ends at the end of your hair, the nail will turn yellowish and dry.
All right, thank you, Doc.
You're welcome.
Well, stick around. We have answers. We'll answer some of your questions about nail health when Healthy Living returns.